guys, welcome back. This is Bretta here, bringing you another trove video. Yeah. So, this is gonna be another tutorial, but this is actually going to be a tutorial on fishing. So, right now, this is where fishing starts for you guys. What you wanna do is you wanna go over to this pirate salesman and Saltwater Sam, that's what he's called, and you want to buy a basic fishing rod. Now this is the first fishing rod that you can buy. It's actually the only one that you can buy. The other ones you have to craft with stuff that you get from fishing. And you also want to buy yourself, like that, a bunch of lures. So when you have done that, you can actually go fishing by pressing F. It will actually throw out, as that guy demonstrates really good. I'm not gonna pronounce his name. Sliff Jacob. Okay, so that wasn't so difficult to pronounce. Thanks for the help, man. Good job. So yeah, you throw it, and when it starts jumping up and down, you just press F again, and then it pulls in, and Bob's your uncle. You catch some stuff. So also, I've got an awesome mount right now, which fits with my pirates perfectly. So I don't recommend fishing. That guy's gonna drown like that. That's wow. Don't do that, people. Don't try that at home. So I wouldn't recommend going fishing in the hub world. I wouldn't recommend going fishing in your club world, because the only things that I've caught when I was doing that were jumping jadefish. But I do actually recommend going fishing in adventure worlds. Now I don't know how this is. I don't think that the difficulty of Adventure World actually has an effect on what you are going to catch, but I personally always go fishing in a Uber 1 world, just because it's not too difficult in Uber 1 worlds. You don't have to like worry a lot about the mobs killing you or anything, because they're probably not gonna. There is some rubber banding going on right now, which is horrible, especially on a video. But yeah, so you kind of want to make your way over to the water, and you can actually choose where you want to fish in some sort of way, because you can fish from the land, from right here, or you can actually activate your boat, shoot some stuff, and actually go out into the middle of the sea where there are not going to be many mobs. Like, when you're fishing on shores, mobs might attack you, and they sometimes, you know, you're still fishing and you don't want to waste your lure, so you you can just fish in the middle of the water. You won't have any problem with that. So what you do is you press F, and then it will throw out your lure, and you will catch some stuff. And I have caught some stuff, and I'm ready to show it to you in my inventory right here. So this is an old boot. This is Satan's spawn and pure evil itself. If you have been following the Reddit at all, you will know that people hate the old boot. It was added last patch, and it is basically a completely useless item that's been added into the game. I apologize, because my cursor is kind of freaking out. That's OBS's fault. It's kind of displacing my cursor. So where my cursor is right now, that's what I mean, but I'm not gonna be pointing at it. But you will see the little annotation pop up to tell you which item I'm actually pointing at on my screen. So yeah, the old boot is pure evil. You can't do anything with it, so you might as well just throw it overboard. That's the only thing you can do with it. Get rid of it. So, next things. These two, the blue blah 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 and the jumping jadefish, are the least rare fishes you will get. They just give you a bit of glim, actually, and this is not what you are fishing for. In fact, these fish will give you a bit of enchanted wood. These will give you, I don't know, some glim, maybe some flux, I don't really know that anymore. These will give you glim, these will give you glim, these will give you glacial shards, catfish, I don't really know. I think they give you glim. Yeah, so what I'm sure of is that these give you radiant shards, well, 10 of them, and there are some other fancy fishes that you can get. Now, the fish that you're actually fishing for is, I will show him to you right here, these bad boys, the ancient sea fish. These will give you a bit of mastery points and will also give you ancient scales. Now, ancient scales, they are basically the crafting material that you need for everything that's associated with fishing. So if you want a new rod, you're gonna need ancient scales. If you want a new sail, you're gonna need ancient scales. If you want one of the new mounts, you're gonna need ancient scales. If you want a new fishing rod, you're gonna need ancient scales for everything. Everything that you can craft, it's gonna need ancient scales. In the last patch, something new was added into the game, and that's enchanted scales, and you can get them from these fish, I presume. I've never caught one of them before. Actually, I don't know anyone that's caught one of them before. I've been asking around in a bunch of club worlds in the world chat. I haven't met anyone that has caught one of them, but I am pretty sure it has something to do with this fishing pole, because it says a legendary fish, fishing rod set to enchant any fish that swims nearby, and the fish that we're trying to catch are called enchanted fish. So I think there might be a connection there. I'm not too sure. A buddy of mine actually fished a while with the with that particular fishing rod and didn't get lucky. He used up, I don't know, like 2,000 lures or something, big number. So yeah, also you can fish in different liquids. So right now you can fish in water, lava, and chocolate. Plasma hasn't been added yet, but it's gonna be added in the future. So for every different liquid, you're gonna need a different fishing rod. You have the basic fishing rod, which you can buy at the pirate, but there are also the molten magma sifter and the candied fishing cane. So yeah, this is of course for in lava, this is of course for in candy, in chocolate, excuse me. And the Lady of the Lake is, I don't know, it doesn't make such a big difference in my opinion. It doesn't give you luck of the seas like in Minecraft or something, but it still looks pretty cool, so I'm using it in the hopes that I might actually catch a enchanted fish. So yeah, these are a bunch of the different fish. Also, fishing is a great way, in my opinion, to get yourself some more glim, because the ancient sea fish I showed you just a little bit earlier actually gives you 1,000 glim. Yeah, you heard that correct. 1,000 glim. And they're not so rare, so you can basically just, yeah, you can, catch like five of them, and then you have 5,000 glim. And most of the time, I just spent 100, no, 1,800 glim on lures, which gives me, well, 1,800 lures. And then I can fish for a while, and then I'll catch like a bunch of them, which basically means that at the end of the day, I will have tripled my glim collection. So you can buy a bunch of mounts and stuff. It's a good trick. So when you're fishing, it's actually kind of useful to keep your inventory screen open, because you can fish right from your inventory screen. Also, your camera view won't change, because your screen's locked right now, and you can maneuver your mouse independently. So you only have to watch this spot. You don't have to worry about throwing your lure out behind your sail or something where you can't see it, because it's always gonna land right there. And also, when you catch a old boot or something, like right now, wow, that's very convenient. You can just immediately throw it out and fish again, which is also very, very great. While you're fishing, I recommend fishing on your boat in the middle of the water, or when you're on land, deactivating your pet, because when I fish, I actually watch live streams at the same time, just because fishing can be a little bit boring, but it's very rewarding. But when your pet is just jumping up and down and stepping in the water, it makes that splashy sound. It kind of distracts me, and oftentimes I press F to pull in my lure to get my fish, but Actually, it was just a bat that made a splashing noise, not my lure that was jumping up and down. So I just wasted that lure, because every time you throw out your fishing rod, you will actually use a lure. That's why you buy so many of them. So yeah, I hope this tutorial was useful to you guys. If you liked it, please leave a like. It helps me out very much. Leave a comment, subscribe for more content like this. And hope to see you guys in another video. Bye, guys. Oh, wow, okay, so we actually caught a ancient sea fish. That's very convenient. I thought I wasn't gonna get anything there, but I kept recording. So that's actually very convenient. Those are the guys you're actually looking for. So yeah, maybe I can actually show you guys the amount of glim that I'm gonna get now, just because of fishing. Fishing is awesome in this game. So for the guys who actually kept watching and didn't just click away right when I did my outro, you are very smart people. Very, very smart people. Smarter than me, because I actually was about to click stop recording for a second there. Very, very smart people. Oh, let's collect some resources while we try to find a cornerstone plot, which we're not gonna find, probably. So, oh, switch to my mag rider there, unfortunately. So yeah, we're just gonna go back to the club world. Okay. Awesome, I really didn't expect this to happen, by the way. I really didn't. But still it happened, and it's great. So, yeah, you can see 1,000 glim for that one. This one gives 50 glim and 10 glacial shards. This one just gives a bunch of glim, 10 radiant shards, bunch of glim and flux, a bit of glim. Oh, fairy dust, okay, great. Bit of glim, and a bit of glim. So, let's actually dump all of our fish right in there. Also, this is a very good way to get yourself some, how do you call it? Some mastery rank, because basically when you haven't fished before, all of these fish are gonna be new and you're gonna get a bit of mastery rank for all of them. When you do a bunch of fishing, you'll probably rank up a few times. So yeah, you can see I have gathered a bunch of glim right here. So yeah, it's basically I spent how much? Yeah, 1800 on lures again, including the purchase I just made on this video, and this is what I caught. Great. So yeah, once again, there's still one left. Excellent. Okay, so once again, I hope you guys enjoyed. Please leave a like if you have. Subscribe for more content like this, and if you want the entire outro, you can just rewind back, because I have already done it. Yeah, guys. Bye, and see you in the next video.